the Lumberjacks jumped on Star City pretty quick the other night with a couple of quick touchdowns. Appeared to play, at least to me, the most complete game that they played to date. Provide our viewers your thoughts on how the team played overall.
You know, I was really pleased with the way we played. We still made some mistakes early in the game. Came out really focused. Played with a lot of energy on both sides of the football. We came out, scored quick with the pass to Darvion, and then came back. Got a turnover on a first play, scored with Darvion throwing a pass, which was a new wrinkle for us. And then had a chance to go up 21-0, fumbled on about the 10-yard line. And then we threw an interception on a miscommunication. Receiver ran the wrong route. But we had a chance really to be way up at the end of the first quarter. That was still a concern for us with the turnovers. But overall, when you play that many young kids, I mean, we're really excited about where we're going as a football team. Thought we got it a lot better from week four to week five. I think you're going to keep seeing that when you're playing this many young kids that we're playing, that you're going to keep getting better each week.
Well, you mentioned the interception. Other than giving Star City the ball, and I think we gave it to them maybe inside our own 10 as a result of that interception. Anyway, it was certainly deep in our territory. And, of course, they had a kickoff return for a touchdown. But as I recall, they really only drove the ball one drive, and I think it was probably 50 yards or something like that to score against us. So my point is, it looks like your defense played pretty good. Talk about your defense a little bit.
I think we've been playing well defensively for a while now. Offensively, we kind of struggled, which put more pressure on the defense. And now I think you're seeing our offense is starting to click a little bit, so it's starting to help the defense out some. But, you know, we gave them a short field. They had the ball on the 2-yard line, went in and scored, and then we gave up a late kickoff return that we need to fix. And hopefully we will. And then they had the one drive right before half that they got 4th and 2. We had them in 4th and 2. They had a great play call. We were in man coverage, and they did some motion stuff, got us outflanked, and was able to score a touchdown. But, a team that's been putting up as many points as they have offensively, it was a concern going in. I think they were averaging close to, 40 points a game offensively. And defensively, we played really well. And played with a lot of energy, got a lot of guys to the football, and something that we can build on from last week to this week.
Well, let's look at the other side, your offense, which seemed to have started clicking considerably better 2 weeks ago and continue to do that against Star City. Both passing and running look pretty effective doing both. So where do you think you are offensively right now?
You know, we're getting better. I think we're improving each day. I think that, you know, we've gotten better from week 3 to week 4, week 4 to week 5, and hopefully we're going to get better from week 5 to week 6. And it's something that we want to do. We want to be balanced. We want to be able to run the football. We want to be able to throw the football. And right now we're able to do that. And, you know, Clay's been our workhorse. I think he's averaging about 24, 25 carries a game in our big games that we're got him in the game plan. We kind of got away from it against PA and against Camden due to injuries. People didn't understand that. You know, we did as a coaching staff. We knew where we were at as a football team, but a lot of public people didn't know where we were at, you know, because all they see is out there. They don't see how many guys that we don't have. And so we didn't want to get Clay punished in two games that really didn't mean anything. So we kind of, you know, drew him back a little bit and didn't make him run the ball as much. And now we're giving it to him again, and he's going to get 20, 25 touches a night, and we want Justin to keep improving. We're adding more to his playbook every week, and hopefully he will. I thought he did a really good job last week of seeing the blitz and throwing it to the hot receivers and getting it out really quick, and I think that helps pass protection more than anything as a quarterback who gets back there and gets rid of the ball, and because at times they bring more than you can account for.
Well, it appeared to me it was one of the better crowds we've had in a while as far as attendance at the game. I know it's Star City conference game, hadn't been home in a while. Did the kids notice the large crowd? And
oh yeah, I mean, they feed off that. That was a great atmosphere the other night. Hopefully we can have another one this Friday night. And we got a lot of young kids playing, and they're exciting to watch. You know, do we make mistakes? Yes. Are we getting better? Yes. And that's the main thing, is that we want to be really good. You know, week 8, week 9, week 10, week 11, that's where we want to peak at. I thought the times that we were in 06, 07, 08, you know, we peaked earlier in the year, and then we kind of got in a lull. And right now we haven't peaked yet. We have not reached our potential, and I think we're still a few weeks away from that because of so many young guys who haven't played that haven't played much. And, you know, like Jalen Marshall, we talked about this morning, who's starting a receiver for us, and D-back, he didn't play much as an eighth grader. as a ninth grader, he got hurt in 2 days, didn't play. So he ain't played football in 2 years. So it's his first year playing football. Same thing with Calix Harris, who's starting linebacker for us. Justin Gorman, sophomore. So, you know, you're talking about a lot of young kids who don't have very much experience. And as they're getting experience, they're getting better.
Well, next on the list is Dumas. And what do they do on offense and defense? I know you've looked at them, I'm sure, but now what do you expect out of them?
You know, they're similar to us. They run a spread-type offense. They got some really good athletes like they always do. They're big up front. You know, right now they've struggled a little bit. CrossFit beat them by 7 last week. They beat Lake Village 54-24 the first conference game. And, you know, they're 1-4 coming in, but they always play us tough. You know, Dumas is always – even back in the earlier 2000s, they always got up to play us, and I don't expect no difference Friday night. You know, we got to be ready to play, and we got to be ready to improve from week 5 to week 6, and I think we will. I think we've had 2 really good days of practice this week. I can see it. We got some guys back, which is fun. It's fun to practice when you got guys back. It's been hard to even have enough to go through practice with so many linemen being out, and now we're starting to get them back, and that's exciting. That's fun, and our kids are – we'll get more of a break. I think you'll see them more fresh, and we'll have Adam Nolan back Friday night, which is, you know, Shiloh game was our best lineman. You know, he graduated out the highest, and then we hadn't had him since then. So we're excited about that. We're excited getting him back, and then you know, we're excited about where Justin is, where he's at right now, and then our receivers are starting to catch the ball, make yards after catch, and we just got to just, you know, correct a couple mistakes, and I think we'll be a really good football team.
So from the injury standpoint, we're getting better.
We're getting better. We only have 2 out. You know, we've been having 5 or 6 out the last few weeks. Now we only have 2. We got Daquan, who broke his leg in the first game, and then Jacob Rao, who hurt his back in the first quarter against the PA game. They're the only 2 injuries we have right now, and hopefully we're going to get them back in the next couple of weeks. And that'll make us as healthy as we were since August 20th. So we're really excited about that.
Great. Well, I hope they all get healed up and get back out there. I want to ask you a question. I've often heard throughout my lifetime of watching football, coaches and players often talk about homecoming. This is homecoming week for Warren, so there'll be a lot of extra activities going on. Does that create any problems from a preparation standpoint or a focus standpoint? Have you noticed that over the years, and what do you think about this team?
Well, not here it hasn't. We have our coronation or whatever you want to call it, 12:30, I make the kids that are in that. We only have 9 this year that are in that. There are 7 seniors and then 2 juniors that are going to be in that, and I make them stay off their feet. But as soon as that's over with, I get them at 1:30. I don't let them go to the parade, and so from 1:30 to 7, I have them. So it's not. I've always done that here. They don't let them go to the parade. I don't let them go uptown, let them go home. They come straight to the field house. We'll watch film till 3 o'clock. We'll go eat our pregame meal. And everything else is just like a game after that. But, you know, it could be if you let it be. We've not let it be here. I've been here, I think, it's the 13th year, and we've never had a problem with homecoming. We do get out of school early, but our kids don't. You know, our kids stay here. So it's just like a normal day to them.
Well, once again, good luck. Look forward to another great game Friday night and a big crowd of Lumberjack fans there.
All right, thank you.